गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द इनकम टैक्स क्लासेस। सो हियर इज द क्वेश्चन, सीरी क्वेश्चन। श्री गोविंदा, रेसिडेंट ऑफ मुंबई, सबमिट्स द फॉलोइंग प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट फॉर द ईयर एंडिंग 31st March 2019। सो डेबिट आइटम्स इज गिवन, क्रेडिट आइटम्स इज गिवन, ईयर ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट ऑल्सो गिवन, and profit and loss account also given. See, opening stock is given, purchases is given, wages is given, sales is given, closing stock is given. So for opening stock and closing stock there is a adjustment here. See, opening stock and closing stock were overvalued by 10%. If in case overvaluation of opening stock is given, we need to treat it as allowable, right? Next, overvaluation of closing stock is given, we need to treat or we need to deduct from the net profit, right? So that is the first adjustment. Already you know the adjustment. Next, so purchases already debited to profit and loss account, no need to consider anywhere. Wages already debited, no need to take. Sales, no need to take. Next, some incomes is given here. So rent, so usually gross property is given, no, we will not consider rent. It's a house property income, right? So rent is given, it's a non-business income, we need to take under the heading non-business income. Next, commission is given, commission is related to business, so we need not to consider anywhere. Next, bad debts record earlier disallowed, in the sense we need to take under the heading non business income credited to profit and loss account. Why? Because it's earlier disallowed, right? In previous problem earlier allowed is given, but in this problem earlier disallowed, in the sense we need to treat it as a non business income. Next, dividend on SRM limited and shares. So SRM limited shares, in the sense it's a non business income, we need to take under the heading non-business income credited to profit and loss account. Next, some debit items is given. Advertisement, 2 lakhs. For advertisement, there is an adjustment. See, so advertisement includes 1 lakh being cost of permanent signboard. Permanent signboard, whenever I explain the theory, I'll explain the adjustment. Permanent signboard, in the sense, we need to treat it as a disallowable. Are you getting? Permanent in the sense it's a permanently fixed to the sign boards. It's a disallowable. 1 lakh we need to treat as a disallowable. Next, salary to staff, it's allowable, no need to take anywhere. Next, go in the salary, it's a disallowable. Why? Because he's a owner, right? Owner salary, we need to treat it as a disallowable. Next, audit fees, allowable, no need to take. Bad debts, allowable, no need to take. Next, reserve for bad debts. Any amount is reserved for bad debts, we need to treat it as a disallowable. We need to take under the heading disallowable expenses debited to profit and loss account. Next, general expenses. So general expenses, 2,50,000 is given. For general expenses, there is an adjustment. See, general expenses include ₹50,000 paid for securing business orders. So paid for business, securing the business orders, in the sense it's allowable, right? We no need to take this 50,000 anywhere. It's already debited to general expense. It's already included to general expenses. We no need to take this 50,000 anywhere. And ₹60,000 spent on Govinda's birthday. So Govinda's birthday, in the sense, he's a owner, it's related to his personal, right? We need to take this 60,000 as a disallowable expenses. Are you getting? Yes. Next, municipal tax is a disallowable. Fire insurance premium on goods, it's related to business, no need to take anywhere. Next, depreciation, 78,000 is given. It's as per the books, 78,000 is given. So but they given in the adjustment. See, depreciation allowable on all assets including the permanent signboard, but excluding the patent rights as per income tax rules was ₹90,000. So they given patents also, but patents depreciation not included here. This 90,000 we need to take under the heading allowable expenses. Why? Because it's as according to income tax rules. According to income tax rules, in the sense, we need to treat it as an allowable. So they given in the profit and loss account, no, 78,000. This 78,000 we need to take it as a disallowable. But this 90,000 we need to treat it as an allowable. Next, patent rights. See, patent rights purchased 1,60,000. So any capital assets purchased, we need to take disallowable rate. For business purpose also, we need to take it's a disallowable expenses. 1,60,000 they purchased. See, for patent they given adjustment. See, patent rights were acquired on 11-10-2018. So 11-10-2018, on which depreciation allowable at 25%. So in previous problem they did not given any depreciation, but in this problem they given depreciation of 25%, right? It's according to income tax rules, it's the standard 25%. So when we our previous year will start 1-4-2018 to 31st March 2019, right? They purchased on 11-10-2018. So 11-10-2018 to, we need to calculate the days here. 11-10-2018 to 31st March 2019. 10 in the sense, it's October, right? October, November, December, January, February, March. We need to take for this period days. October, how many days? 10, 11, 30 purchase. In October, 30 days, no? 30 days in the sense, 20 days we need to take. Why? Because already 10 days is over. From 11th, we need to take. Next, November. Sorry, in October, 31 days. So, 21 days. So, November, 30 days. December, 31 days. January, 31 days. February, 28 days. March, 31 days. So we need to take total days. So 90 days, 120 days, 150, 171 days, 160, 172 days, total 172 days. Why this I am calculating in the sense, so if in case any capital assets purchased and it's using less than 182 days, less than 182 days they are using in the business, we need to take half of the depreciation. Whenever I am explaining the theory, see that videos, okay? So I explain this 182 days concept, right? So only patents use 172 days. So we need, if they use more than 182 days, we need to take entire 25%, isn't it? So they did not use more than 182 days. They only used 172 days. That's why we need to take half of the depreciation. Whenever we are solving the problem, we will see the question. Next, staff welfare plan, it's a disallowable. Next, employees RPF, it's also disallowable. Sales tax is related to business. It's allowable expense, no need to take. It's already debited. Donation to NDF, it's a disallowable. Next, premium on Govinda's life. Govinda's life insurance, it's a personal right because Govinda is a owner. So, it's a disallowable. We need to take under the heading disallowable expenses debited to profit and loss account. And net profit also given 4,16,000. Next, any adjustment we left? Opening stock, closing stock, you know how we will treat. Next, advertisement, I explain. Next, see, business income of rupees 70,000 was not recorded in the profit and loss account. We need to record now under the heading business incomes not credited to profit and loss account. Under the heading, we need to add for the net profit. Okay, are you getting this adjustment? This first adjustment we are seeing in this question. Next, general expenses I explained, depreciation I explained, patents I explained. Maybe are you getting these six adjustments, right?
Next, see the solution. So net profit as per profit and loss account, they given 416,000 in the question. See, 416,000 we need to take. Next, add disallowable expenses or business incomes not credited to profit and loss account. This two adding. So first, business income. Business income not debited, not credited, no, not recorded. This 70,000 we need to take under this heading. Business incomes not credited to profit and loss account. Business income 70,000. Next, advertisement. See, advertisement include 1 lakh being cost of permanent signboard. Cost of permanent sign, nothing but it's a disallowable 1 lakh we need to treat. Next, go in the salary, disallowable, no, we treated. Next, reserve for bad debts, we treated. Next, general expenses. So for general expenses, see, general expenses include 50,000 paid for business orders. So this already debited to profit and loss account, no need to take. Next, 60,000 spent on Govinda's birthday. So Govinda's birthday, in the sense, it's a disallowable, no. So general expenses within the bracket, Govinda's birthday expenses 60,000. It's a disallowable, no, we need to treat. Next, municipal tax, disallowable. Next, depreciation, they given in the profit and loss account 78,000, disallowable. But they given in the adjustment also. In adjustment, we need to take it as a allowable. Next, patent rights purchased 160,000. Patents 160,000 is given. Next, staff welfare fund 60,000, that is also disallowable. Next, donation to NDF, disallowable. Next, premium on Govinda's life insurance 36,000. Next, overvaluation of opening stock. If in case undervaluation of opening stock is given, we need to take under this heading. So here overvaluation of opening stock is given, we need to add 110,000 into 10 by 110. So here some printing mistake. So 110,000 into 10 divided by 110. Are you getting? See, 110,000 into 10 divided by 110. 110,000 we will get. 110,000 into 10 divided by 110. 10,000 we will get. If we add all the disallowable expenses, you will get 8,48,000. Net profit 4,16,000 and 8,48,000 disallowable expenses, you will get 12,64,000. Next, overvaluation of closing stock, same as usual. Wait a minute. 2,20,000 into 10 divided by 110 into 10,20,000. So 1,10,000 overvaluation of opening stock, 2,20,000 divided by 110 into 10. Otherwise you will take it here like this. 2,20,000 into 10 divided by 110. If you treat it like this also, you will get same answer. Okay. Next, depreciation allowable as per income tax rules, the given in the adjustment 90,000. Next, depreciation on patent rights. So patent rights, they purchased. See, they purchased patent rights 1,60,000. No, when they purchased 11-10-2018, they purchased. We need to calculate the days. So if we calculate the days, we will get 172 days. But if they are using less than 182 days, we need to consider half of the depreciation. See, depreciation 1,60,000 into 25% given in the question into half. Why we are taking half? They are not using more than 182 days. That's why we are considering half of the depreciation. So 20,000 you will get. Next, rent. It's a non-business incomes, right? Rent, bad debts recovered, earlier disallowed is given. Dividends on SRM limited shares are given. So if we add allowable and non-business income, you will get 4,70,000. If you deduct from 12,64,000,
minus 470,000, you will get taxable income from business 794,000. Are you getting? If you are not getting, once again go through the video.